Centuries of wave action, freezing, and thawing have sculpted shorelines throughout the Apostle Islands. Some of the Great Lakes' most spectacular scenery occurs where nature has carved delicate arches, vaulted chambers, and hidden passageways into shoreline exposures of the Devil's Island formation. These sea caves honeycomb sandstone cliffs on Devil's Island, Sand Island, and here near Mauaque Bay on the mainland. The forces of nature are constantly whittling away at the islands. Some shorelines erode more quickly than others. Thick carpets of till composed of sand, gravel, and clay left behind by the glaciers cover many of the islands. Bluffs like those on the north side of Oak Island are eroded fairly easily and produce much of the sand found on Apostle Island's beaches. The bedrock underlying most of the islands is sandstone of the Shawamigan Formation. Braided rivers carrying huge amounts of sediment into the region about a billion years ago were the source of the thick layers of this very hard sandstone. Shawamigan sandstone creates massive cliffs with few caves. However, some shorelines, like the northeast coast of Stockton Island, do exhibit interesting rock pillars called sea stacks. The largest at Stockton, shown here, is known as the Balancing Rock. The Devil's Island sandstone has very thin layers, making it much softer and more easily eroded than the Shawamigan sandstone. Incessant pounding from wind and waves over the past 10,000 years since the retreat of the glaciers have turned these shorelines into natural works of art. There are certain times when these art galleries are accessible for viewing. On calm summer days, the caves at Devil's, Sand, and on the mainland are popular destinations for visitors in kayaks, boats, and dinghies. This is when boaters can probe the cave's deepest recesses and enjoy the guttural murmurs of waves lapping against the rock. The caves may be most spectacular in the dead of winter, when frigid temperatures turn the surface of Lake Superior into a frozen white expanse. Lakeshore cliffs form a crimson border to this Arctic landscape. Pillars of ice extend to cliff tops where waterfalls have hardened in place. Frozen lake water encrusts the base of the cliffs, while inside the caves is a fairyland of needle-like icicles. Ice formations change constantly with the weather. Mauaque Bay, near Myers Beach on the mainland, is frequently covered with ice for some or all of the period from late January to late March. If the bay is sufficiently frozen, visitors can walk across the ice to visit the sea caves at this time of year. This is when it's easy to understand that freezing and thawing, as well as wind and waves, are responsible for carving this landscape. Entering the ice-encrusted caves is like crawling into the heart of the winter.